Film Studios, and we're going to speak with Dave Jones, who's the model shop supervisor, and he's going to show us how he uses mathematics and scale when they create props like this so it looks real when we watch movies or watch television.
The reason that we need to decide on one scale when we build a miniature helicopter like this 1/8 scale Sikorsky is that we'll normally have a number of different people working on different parts of the helicopter at the same time. And we want to make sure that the person that's working on the blades or the person that's working on the windows or the landing gear makes that part in scale and in proportion to the rest of the helicopter. When we decide on the scale that we want to use, we'll go out and measure the real helicopter in the case of the Sikorsky. We'll measure a number of what we would call reference measurements. Or we might have to measure every different window and door and item, such as a door handle or the gas filler pipe. From there, we would be able to go and say, in the case of 1/8 scale, we would divide the real measurement by 1/8, and that would give us the height. For example, the window on our miniature is roughly 4 inches across. So on the full-size helicopter, which is 8 times larger, how large would the window be? That would be 32 inches across. Another example is the door handle on the miniature helicopter is 1/2 inch across. Take a look at it there. So if the helicopter is 8 times larger, or 8 to 1 scale from this, how large would the door handle be? Some of the time when we decide upon a scale, it'll be based on the action or the gag that we have to do with a miniature. In the case of this helicopter, it was motion control green screen. It was just put into the air over a stadium and did not have to act or interact directly with what was going on in the film. In the case of Cliffhanger, we decided on a 1/6 scale helicopter, and that was because the action in that was a helicopter falling, crashing into a cliff, part of it breaking off, windows shattering, and at the end some explosions and also some smoke. Because of this, we wanted to use a larger scale. The reason that you would want to use a larger scale is that certain things in nature and physics don't work the same way when they're very small as they do when they're very large or full size. If you were shooting something, say, that had fire in it or that had a lot of water in it, those things typically are thought to not scale down very well. And you would want those in 1/3 scale at the minimum to be able to make the waves look right or the fireball or the smoke look right. So here's a question. How large would this 1/3 scale, 4-foot-long miniature orca be in real life? These are the kind of questions that we work with every day as model makers. And you might want to think about how using scale and measurements can help you in your everyday life or in a future career.